Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen. For the past couple of days, we talked about VLOOKUP, and then yesterday we talked about two seemingly useless functions called index and offset. Now let's go back to VLOOKUP today and see where index can come in very, very handy. Today I have a budget process. We have accounts going down the left-hand side, months going across the top, and from my MIS department, I'm getting some sort of a download every day that has actuals or budget numbers or something like that. It's just a real ugly data set. And I want to be able to take those numbers from the ugly data set and bring it into my formatted data set every day. So I'm going to use the equal VLOOKUP function. Say that I want to grab this account number, and of course I want to hit the F4 key 3 times to make sure that it's always pointing at column A. And then I will use Alt Tab to switch over to the other file, specify my data area. And because this is in another workbook, I don't have to hit F4, it's already selected for me. Which column do I want? I want the second column and then the word false. So that creates the first VLOOKUP. Now, kind of the hassle is, as I copy this over, it's always going to be looking at the second column. So I have to edit each column to change the 2 to a 3, the 3 to a 4, the 4 to a 5. A great workaround for that is just to add maybe a hidden row up here in row 4 with the numbers 2, 3, 4. And then in your VLOOKUP, instead of saying you want the second column, point to $$4. And then as you copy over, it will automatically go to columns 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, we can do that one better if you don't want to add the 2, 3, 4, 5 in a hidden row. There's a great function called the column function. So here, instead of saying I want column 2, I've said I want the column of B1. The column of B1, since B is the second column, is a 2. The nice thing about that is since the B1 is a relative reference, as I copy it over, it automatically changes to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Basically, now I have one formula that works everywhere. But VLOOKUP is a very memory-intensive function. Every time that we do a VLOOKUP in January, it has to go find that account number, look through hundreds of rows of data, figure out which row it's in, and then it does the exact same thing again for February, March, April, May, June. That's where match and index can come in very handy. Here, I've created a brand new column called which row, and later on I'll hide this column. And the which row column uses the match function. Match is very similar to VLOOKUP. It says, hey, go grab that account number in column A, look in our other worksheet through column A, and tell me which row number within the relative range it's on. So here you'll see that this first account is on row 1 in the other worksheet. Now usually that's not very useful information. I've never had a manager call me up and say, hey, what row number is that account on? It's just not something that comes up. And so when I initially saw the match function, I said, well, what good is that? Why do I care what relative row number within a range something's located? But if you think about the index function, we talked about the index function in yesterday's podcast. The index function says, hey, go grab a range of data and give me a specific row and optionally a specific column. So when I built my index function here, I said, I'm going to go over to the other worksheet, look through column B, and I made sure that the B portion was relative. The rows, of course, I want to keep absolute from $2 to $363, but I took the dollar signs out before the B, and then said, which row do I want? I want the row that's called out by this match function in column C. And since I'm only specifying one column, I didn't have to specify which column number. The great thing about that is the match function is memory intensive, but now we only have one match function, one for every row. It's not repeated all the way across. The index function is relatively lightning fast compared to the match function. I have my 12 index functions going across. Just copy those down to all my rows, and it will run much faster than having VLOOKUPs through 12 columns times hundreds of rows. There's one option where index and match makes your spreadsheet work a lot faster because it doesn't have to go through and find the account number 12 times for every row. Now, next time we'll talk about another option for index and match when your data is to the left of the key. But thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.